Hello everyone. Today we will see how to create a poster in MS Word. We'll learn how to put the border in the Word page, how to give a background color or a page color to the Word document, how to insert pictures and write in different types of shapes available in MS Word. So let's start. We are going to make a poster of input devices today. So first thing that I am going to do here is insert a page border. So we go to page layout option on top, that's my menu option, and I go to page borders. Click on it. There is an option on the left hand side called box. I have to click the box option so that the page gets a border. Go here to the art box and there are different types of pictures available. Whichever you like, you can put that. I'm taking this tree and click OK. So it comes as a page border, you see. Now I want to make it a little smaller. The width should be a little smaller. For that, what I should do, go to page border again. Do you see this option of width here? We can reduce the size. Maybe 20 I will make it and click on OK. The size reduces. So whatever size you want, you can put the border like that. Now let's see how to put the page color. We go here to this option. If I click on any particular color, one color will come just like that on the entire page. Now I want maybe more colors. So I go to fill and there are two colors, option of giving two colors to my page. So I can go here and I can choose any particular color that I like. Choose the second color and take it like this, or whichever color you like, you can take that. So these are different options which are available, how you want the page color to be given to you, whether you want it from the center or you want it like this or you want it in a horizontal way. That's up to you. Click on that, okay, and the page color comes for me. You can change it to some preset colors also. Go to fill effects again in the page color option. You have preset. Preset means already the colors are set there. You have just have to choose and put it in your page. So you can choose from any, so many different colors and patterns which are given, or you can choose gold, rainbow, mahogany. There are n number of things which you can use. It's up to you what you want, right? So let's take this maybe peacock color. Okay, and I click on OK. So this is the color which comes for me. Now I'm going to use WordArt to write the title of my poster. So I go to insert. There is an option of WordArt here, which is a decorative text in our document. So click on that. Choose any design that you like. Click on it. And I'm going to write input devices. Click OK. Now this input device, I can, the text I can make big by pulling it like this, dragging it like this. When I click on this word art, on the left hand side on top, you can see these options. One option is spacing. Spacing gives space between my letters. So I choose the, it's very tight now. So you can see all the letters overlapping each other. So I go choose normal, so it becomes separated. So that suits me. So I take that. It's up to you what you want. Now there is a shadow. If you can see, there's a shadow behind this text. If you like it, you can keep it as it is. If you don't like it, you can remove it. So how do we remove that? We go here. There is a shadow effect here. Go to this place, click on no shadow. The shadow will be removed. Or if you want a shadow, you can give a shadow like this, maybe like this. There are different other options available. You can choose as you want. I do not want a shadow, so I'm removing the shadow like this. Okay. Now there is an option to change the shape of this text. We go to change shape and I have all these different types of options. Whichever you like, you can choose. So I'm taking this one and I can use it in my document. Now if I want this input devices title to be at the center of the page, how do I do that? I click on the word art, go to text wrapping option, click on through. So now it allows me to move Till this time, it was not allowing me to move this title. Now I can move it as I want. If I want to change the color, I go here and I will take any color. Suppose I say I want green color, I can go and change it like this. Okay, like this. So now let's see how to put pictures. Go to insert and you can take a picture from your machine if you have it. Otherwise, you can go online and take a picture. So I go to picture. And let me see if I have a picture in my on my machine. Maybe I have. I'll have to go on to Google. So we go here. We go to google.com. And I say I want the picture of a keyboard, which is an input device. I press enter. Go to the image tab. Scroll down, whichever you feel like, you can take that as the picture and right click on it. It will give an option of copy. Copy it, go back to your Word document and control V or right click and paste. So your picture comes here. Now you can reduce the size. Remember, the picture always should be increased or decreased in size from the corner only, because if you drag it from here, the picture becomes like this, which we don't want. And if you drag it from the top down again, this is not the picture that we want. It will get distorted. So the best way to always drag and make a picture larger or smaller is from the corner like this. Okay, so from the corner we drag it and we make it smaller or bigger. And this is this, with this you can rotate the picture, you can make it slightly slanting and all these things. Now, how do I move this picture again? It will not move just like that. See, I'm dragging and it's not allowing me to move the picture. So I click on the picture, go to format option, go to text wrapping, click on through, and now I can drag the picture anywhere that I like. Okay, so this is one picture which I have put. I can give it a border from here. If I do not click on the picture, all these options do not come. You see on top, there is no picture tools option. Picture tools and formatting options only come when we click on the picture. So I click here, formatting comes, and here I can go and choose any type of a shadow or any type of border that I want. So I can make the border nicely like this. I can put the color of the border like this. All these things you can do. Now, after putting the picture, I would like to write the name. So to write the name, let's put a shape and insert the shape. Inside the shape, we are going to give the title or the name of this picture. So let's take this one and I do it like this. How do I type? Now, inside this, you right click. There is an option, add text. Add text. So click on add text. The cursor comes inside. Now I can type the name of this picture. It's keyboard. So I select it. I increase the size and I can use any font which I think will look nice for this. And I can increase the size like this. Make it center aligned so that it comes in center of this shape. You can put a color, add a color to fill the shape. How do I do that? The shape should be clicked on. Go to text box tools. There is a shape fill option. You can choose a color for this also. So it will give you a shape. You can rotate it to match the shape like this. And then you can give a different color for the text. So let's take a red color, which I have put here. So it comes like this. Another picture you can add. Go on to Google. Take a picture of, say, microphone, and in microphone we have all these pictures. You may choose anyone which you like. This one I can take, right click, copy image, come to Word, and here right click, paste, or control V, again make the picture smaller. So it comes here. I cannot move it unless I use the text wrapping option. So I click on the picture, go to picture tools, text wrapping, Click on through and it allows me to move the picture. So I can tilt it if I want. Okay, now here you see that the picture has a background of white color. I will try to remove it. There is an option here. Let's see if it works. So click on the picture. On the left hand side, you have recolor option. At the bottom of it, you have set transparent color. Click on that. Click on this picture and the background goes away. So the picture that I have taken from Google becomes a transparent one and I can use it. Now I can give it a border, whichever way I like, and give it a color also. So this one is very thick. Let's take a smaller one. Okay, so like this, maybe you can give. That's up to you. What is your creativity? You can show it. Okay, so similarly, you're going to write the text for this and you're going to make this poster. So for input devices, you can put 3 to 4 pictures. I would like to show you another one which I have already made. This one. So this is one picture which I have already made of input devices. You can use like this. So all these options, put, give a border, give a page color, use word art, take the pictures, give a border to the pictures. All these options can be used to make a poster. So use these options, children, and enjoy making the poster. Bye for now.